Well, what do you think of my new theater?
Bit over the top.
You're wearing a suit.
I got it from a friend.
No. Anytime you come here, I want you to wear the tightest jeans possible.
It does an actor good to play a truly joyous character, someone in love with life. And that's what's going on with Sean Penn in the very good new film, Milk. Harvey Milk was the San Francisco city supervisor who was gunned down, along with Mayor George Moscone, by Milk's unstable former colleague, Dan White. Now that was in 1978, and the film very wisely does not try to tell the whole story of Milk, who hit San Francisco with his boyfriend, played by James Franco, in the early 70s, just when the Castro district was taking off. Here's the great thing about what Penn is doing here. His performance works equally well if you're familiar with the real-life subject or not. He plays this unlikely politician who turned his modest little camera store into a power base for the Castro neighborhood with real zest and delight. And this is a dicey discussion topic, but here goes. You don't get that slight air of make-believe condescension you do when some straight actors take on a gay role the way, say, William Hurt did in Kiss of the Spider Woman. Milk was directed by Gus Van Sant, who's worked both sides of the filmmaking street, studio-style work like Good Will Hunting, as well as more challenging independent projects. I'd say this Harvey Milk biography takes the best of both sides. It's polished, a little conventional in the filmmaking and the writing, but there's real grace and intelligence at work, and the film is uniformly well acted, including sharp performances from Josh Brolin as the grievously troubled Dan White, and Emil Hirsch as one of Milk's friends and allies. But this is Penn's show. He's tremendous and very moving in the role, and I suspect you're going to hear Penn's name come Oscar nomination time. 3.5 stars for Milk. For the Chicago Tribune, I'm Michael Phillips.